football for like...
Hey, we're just chatting with my good friend. This would be Shane Victorino, the very newest Boston Red Sox. Shane, good morning to you, my friend.
Hi, thank you.
How it feels to be a Red Sox? Because obviously you spent the past season with the Dodgers, but now you're putting on a whole new uniform. Excited? Feelings that you have about being in Boston?
I'm definitely excited for this opportunity to go to a historic franchise, to go to a organization that, you know, they call it Red Sox Nation, and it's everywhere. So I'm very excited for the opportunity to go to Boston to be part of a winning franchise and to be part of a team that I think, you know, is on the verge of turning things around. And, you know, the last couple years has definitely been frustrating for them, but the end of the day, you know, we always look to the new. We don't look back at what has happened. And I think that the organization, I think, has taken steps to make us better, you know, from every aspect of the game. So, you know, having the new managers, having some new players and, you know, additions to the team, you know, I'm very excited with, you know, really the good guys that are already there.
I was looking, Tyzo, this is one of his prized items that he has. It has Shane Victorino and, of course, that trademark number 8. I looked it up, my friend, and I forgot, and heaven forbid, Red Sox Nation, forgive me, Carl Yastrzemski wore number 8.
Yes.
So what are we going to see you in next year?
Secret has it, I'll be going to 18. So,
still got an 8 involved.
Yes, I got an 8 involved. So, yes, I'm going to be wearing the number 18. And I head to Boston this week to get my physical and make this final, make it official. And so, again, I'm very excited, to be back home here, but yet be, heading to Boston this coming week.
Do you like the fact that obviously played many, many years and sort of made your name in Philadelphia? They're a very passionate fan base. So you're kind of used to this, aren't you?
Oh, I'm definitely going to be used to this, playing East Coast baseball. But again, it's two different entities, two different cities. And, again, I'm going to go out there. I'm just going to have fun. I'm not going to do anything different. We'll stay within the
ballpark,
just be myself
and
play hard. And that's, all I can do. And, at the end of the day, if I know and I go out there and I give 100%, that's all I can ask.
This past weekend, we had Manti Te'o on Saturday finish second in the Heisman voting. And we've seen how amazing he's been at representing the 50th state. And that's something that I know you take a great deal of pride in, is letting folks know you're from here and what this means. What do you hope people get from you when you represent our state?
As Manti, I had the luxury of going to see him, to see him in his senior game, his final game at home at Notre Dame, and, got to spend a couple days with him, and, what I got out of it and what we've learned and what I continue to strive for is that, to be a role model, to be an inspiration, to let kids know that, hey, if you set your dreams high, go after them, and things are, anything's possible. And, Manti is another perfect example, and in his speeches, and if you listen to him, he talks about the word Ohana. He talks about coming from the 50th state and being from Hawaii and going out there and his love and his passion for the game, is great on the field, but what he does off the field, and being an inspiration for others, for kids from Hawaii. And, what he always says is that he wants kids to look up to him, to say that, hey, if your dreams and you set your goals high, anything's possible. A kid that, basically to me turned, Notre Dame football around. Recent years they haven't been the greatest of teams, but, this year being undefeated, going a national championship game, and to me being arguably the best player. Unfortunately, he didn't win the Heisman, which we all thought, and I thought he deserved. But it's one of those things that But again, you look at how he handled it, how he took it, and after his post interview, and at the Heisman, he said, "Hey, winning a national championship to me is more important." And to me, that shows what he means to the word team. And he's about the team. Heisman Trophy, yeah, it's an individual award, it's an individual accolade. But again, he deflected that and said, "Hey, to me, winning a national championship would be the biggest thing." So,
and I heard him talk, and I know I've heard you talk before. I know that you're extremely grateful to your parents and what they've passed on to you, and you hear him talking about that. It's just neat to see a young man that understands how important family is to who you are.
Oh, it's very important. And most of you guys know my father, for what it is and stuff like that. But, my mom and dad, they were always there to support me. And not only my mom and dad, my brothers, my family, and I use the word Ohana, and that's, something that's very important to me. And without the support of them, without that kind of a supportive wife and kids and cheering me on and bouncing from one city to another and all these kind of things, it's very special for me to be able to have that support, to have that family, and to do these kind of things, and have the support of the 808 state.
All right, well, we see in your Dodger uniform there, you're trading in the Dodger blue for a Red Sox uniform, and we look forward. Have a great season.
Thanks,
folks here really do cheer for you, even though I know know it's very difficult for John Benary. He's got, like, this New York Yankee thing going on. So I think he's pulling for you reluctantly, but he's pulling for you just the same.
Thank you.
But congratulations.
Thanks,
and you're going to look great in that Red Sox uniform. And I know they're getting one heck of a center fielder, that's for
sure.
Thank
you very much.
All right. Wake Up Today is going to continue. We've got to get linked with Lanai. And you heard it here first. He's probably going to be wearing that number 18 when it comes to putting on the Boston Red Sox uniform. Stay with us right here on Wake Up Today.